how to utilize the single axis lever control pod, which is an option in the next gen small wheel loaders. So just like the joystick pod, you can adjust it forwards and back independent of the seat, so the two move separate. You can also index up the armrest or the wrist rest all the way to the top, resets it, and you can find the setting that's good for you. Now, programmable buttons are now available through the two yellow buttons, and as you start the machine, you'll be greeted with a splash screen which tells you what they are, but of course you can change them to your individual preferences. The factory defaults are going to be horn and differential lock on the front. Now, when it comes to implement control, single axis levers do just that. They give you control of a single function at a time. So as an example, you can see as I pull the first one, it's going to rack the bucket in. As I pull the second one, it's actually going to lift the implements. And as I pull the third one, that would be auxiliary flow control. And as an option, of course, you can get a fourth one for dual or two auxiliary flows. Now, to set your kickouts, it works just like it does on a joystick style machine, where we put the implements where we want them, we reach over to our soft touch button panel, and we do a 2 second push and hold. Beep, it will memorize, and it's told me that it's memorized the tilt position. Now I can also, because I'm in my lower state, memorize my lower position. Now I can come up to my trench, my hopper, my trench, whatever it is, the feed wagon, a truck, and I can reach over and push and hold, beep. I can memorize the upper position. So that quickly, I've programmed them for this bucket attachment I've got on. Now what we can do is we can now manually rack that bucket on in, and then I'm going to use the first of the detents. I'm going to pull it into the full extreme, into the soft detent. It's going to raise up to that target point. It's going to electronically snub when it gets there. After I achieve that upper lift, I can manually dump it back out, and then I can recall the second, return to a level condition automatically with the throw of the joystick, all the way to the lower position through that soft detent to command that lower position. So you can see very similar controls, but gives you single axis control at one time. So as you do a dig cycle, it's still going to be plunge, lift, set your tires, and then multi-function lift and rack up through the pile to get a full bucket every time. Now, when you have a machine that's equipped with a steering wheel, the forward and reverse indicator will be right here on the single axis pod. This machine is also equipped with the optional force feedback stick steer system. And when it's equipped with that option, the forward and reverse is actually going to be on the joystick on the left hand side. So there's only a single forward and reverse shift in any single machine. Now, also park brake will be brought to the pod, as well as our implement lockout. And if we want to make a customization to what the program buttons are, we would actually come in here to our machine. We would dial to advanced, and then from advanced, we would choose our joystick button options. And you can see here, horn and diff lock are the current programmed, but we can actually dial that through a range of things: max wheel torque, override, continuous flow set, speed range up, speed range down, bucket shakeout, payload add, payload store, or we can actually disable that button so there's none. So a lot of customization in the control pod itself. As an option or as an exchange, this can be kitted on the next generation small wheel loader through your dealer.